And I think what Chris has done is he's taken the best of Batman and then sort of the coolest bits of his aesthetic and joined them together. He didn't allow the sort of preconceived notions about what Batman could be to stop him from, you know, using Batman to explore like more serious parts of ourselves. That's the real leap that happened when Batman Begins came out. The first feeling you got was that this is definitely not made in a boardroom. This is like someone's point of view on this. You watch The Dark Knight Rises, you watch any of these three movies, and you feel every part of the movie you're seeing, the sets, the acting, the movie itself is a thing that has been physically constructed. The craftsmanship comes across. It's not made by a machine or by a computer or a committee. It's made by men and or women. It's a craft, you know, it needs craftsmen to do it. There's a tactile feeling about the movies. It's really palpable. You can feel it when you watch them.
We give it back to you, the people.
With Batman Begins, when we came to market the film, it was a bit of a shock to realize how difficult it was to convey to the audience that this was something different. That if they'd been disenchanted with the idea of going to see a Batman film, that no, we're starting all over, this is something you haven't seen before.
His goal was obviously to give a whole new birth to this particular property, and it had to look and feel utterly different. Luckily, the assets and ideas and motifs that Chris gave us all in his concepts, these things gave us a natural place to go to.
We tried not to think about this film as a superhero film.
So we took that first trailer and decided to reinvent it as a completely different animal.
They told me there was nothing out there, nothing to fear.
The first teaser trailer that went out for Batman Begins, it was a pretty radical approach. I think people found it a little disconcerting.
I went around the world, searched in all the shadows.
Because we were sort of showing them images that they wouldn't expect to see in that kind of film.
And there is something out there in the darkness. Something terrifying. Something that will not stop until it gets revenge.
You know, Batman wasn't in it until just a brief flash at the end.
Me.
I think that kind of approach has been very, very influential. And we actually try to follow that thread through the marketing of all three films, really trying to always do something a little different and a little surprising.